G'day, Joey here. I just want to celebrate 50 years of the release of this album, Led Zeppelin, famous Led Zeppelin album, Houses of the Holy, and wanted to have a look at one of my favourite songs from the album, which is Dancing Days. Really nice, fun guitar song to play. So let's get stuck straight into it. I'll put up tabs as I go, roughly three bars at a time. So we're starting off with these two notes, a G note and a C sharp. You'll see, you'll notice two things on the bars that I've put up, the tabs that I've put up, sorry. These are straight out of the book. Supposedly the key is C or A minor. I think that's debatable. The chords, bit the partial chords and notes that are played sort of go all over the place. So I don't know what key you'd call it, but I'm not sure you'd call it C or A minor. Here, and the second thing to note is that the tabs say it's a G chord, but obviously that's not a G chord. You don't have a C sharp in a G chord. So that starts to give us a hint of what kind of key we're talking about. You do have a C sharp in the G blues scale, yeah? That's a C sharp there, the diminished fifth. So you might argue that's roughly where this song sort of placed. And then, as you go from that C sharp to the D note there, you're actually going from a G diminished to a G5. And then you're back to that B note, which is in a G chord. We're up to bar four there. I'll just play that bit again. So we're sliding from playing these two notes on the 7th fret to the 5th fret there. So they're parts of a D chord and a C chord. I'm muting my G string. Of course, you could play this with your fingers. That'll work fine. I've always been used to playing it with a pick, so that's what I do. And then you repeat the whole thing again. And then we're up to just the very end of that second repeat, you see on bar six there. Open G and then a B flat, and then I'm sliding right up to the 10th fret. Now we're up to the next, we're up to the verse now, bar 7. So now we're up to the actual start of the chorus, bar 12. So we finish the... We go straight into that C6 chord. Notice how the accent's always on the half beat before the bar, and that happens throughout this song. Pretty much every bar. You're accenting a half beat before the start of the bar. That's an important part of getting the feel of the song. So we're playing this C6 on the 10th fret and toggling between the C major triad there and the C6. down the B flat. Then we're up to the end, the very end of the bar 13 there. You'll see it says an A major chord, but actually these three notes, this triad we're hitting, is part of a D minor. Once again, half beat before the start of the bar. And then these two notes we pick up, the next two notes are the C sharp and E. They indeed are part of an A major, but then you're sort of toggling between A and B flat. So do that again. Really like this bit when we go. Because these three notes, C sharp, A and F, create an F augmented, or an A augmented. They're identical notes. That's a very nice way to end it. And then you just repeat the last two notes by doing that slide from the G to the A, and end on that F again. Back, repeat. Slide again, and then repeat from the start again. Anyway, we'll leave it there. I only just want to do that bit. One thing to note is the few fills that I showed. There are a million variations in that throughout the song. Jimmy Page is almost doing something slightly different each time you go around, as is John Paul Jones on the bass. So the bass is roughly following these sort of chord patterns. But he too does slightly different little fills as the song goes on, slightly different variations each time. And it's a fun song to play if you ever want to sort of jam with mates. You can have a ball doing this and then just doing these tiny little fills. But basically playing these same notes that I've just shown you in slightly different timing or different patterns or whatever. All right, hope you enjoyed that. One of my favourite Led Zeppelin albums, House of the Holy, that was Dancing Days. All right, thanks for watching. See ya, bye-bye.